you ever think about make money, but how can I make money just by earning your regular salary? So definitely making less money is obviously the method to become rich. My name is Shua Yuan. I'm an accounting major, senior accounting major. Today I'm presenting about making less money into electronic commerce company, the Alibaba Holding Group Limited and the Amazon.com. The general area of my research is about electronic commerce, which means all the business transactions is made through a computer and electronic device. Both the Alibaba Holding Group Limited and the Amazon.com are the electronic commerce company. So it is efficiency to compare the financial statement of these two companies because they are the same type of company. And the business model of these two companies is the business to customer, customer to customers. These two companies are not only the biggest in the electronics commerce area, but also they have the most significant impact on the investment market. The market capital is the total market value of the outstanding of a public company, and the market cap for Alibaba is 162 billion, and for Amazon is 245 billion, which disclose both these companies has big market capital to influence the investment market. So obviously, it is profitable to make investment in these two companies because not only online business is more popular right now, so there will be more people starting using electronic commerce in today's world and in their life. Since these two companies are doing a so great job, here I got a question. So which one of them should I invest? So I propose my research question that which one of the companies should I invest in order to obtain more earnings? I've been doing research on the financial statement, cash flow, balance sheet, and income statement from 2014, 2013 to 2015 of these two companies in order to draw a conclusion to answer my research question. The first thing I detect is that the Amazon.com's 2014 net income is a negative number, which is not a good thing because they are not making any money for that year. They are also losing money in 2014. The next thing I calculate is the sales growth rate. The sales growth rate is calculated by using the net sales this year minus the net sales last year and divided by last year's net sales, which gave us a ratio that tells about the growth rate of the sales of the company. Start from the number, we can clearly see that Alibaba Holding Group Limited, from 2014 to 2015, the number drops down from 52.1% to 45.6%, and the Amazon company increased from 19.5 to 20.2, which is, even though the Alibaba company has the higher number of the growth rate, but the growth rate is going down from 2014 to 2015. But the Amazon company is growing, the sales growth rate is growing from 19 to 20. The next thing I calculated is earnings per share. The earnings per share, which give us an idea that how much we could earn by invest one share in each one of the company. And the earnings per share is calculated by net income minus the dividend on the preferred stock and divided by the average outstanding shares. So I got the earnings per share for Alibaba company is 4.1, and Amazon Amazon's earnings per share is 1.25, which gives us an idea that definitely Alibaba has the better earnings per share than the Amazon company. The next thing I calculate is the profit margin. Profit margin, which is it measures the profitability of the owner's major interest and the process of market production. The profit margin for Alibaba is 73.09, and the Amazon's profit margin is only 0.56, which gave us, this is a huge difference between these two numbers, between their profit margin. We could definitely see that the Alibaba's net income is using efficiency on investment. The next thing I calculate is the profit percentage. The profit percentage is also the return on investment, which gave us an idea about how much we could get after we invest in this company. And it's calculated by the net profit divided by the cost price. So I got Alibaba profit percentage calculated to be 220%, and the Amazon's is only 49%. This gives us an idea that Alibaba is obviously doing a great job because they have more return on investments. Lastly, I did a calculation for the enterprise value divided by revenue, which is measuring the healthy of the stock price of each company. And it's also answering the question of what the company is being valued per share of revenue. So as I calculated, the Alibaba's enterprise value divided by revenue is 11.74, and Amazon is 2.44. This number, which means like that the smaller number disclose that the healthier. If the number is smaller, then the company's stock price is healthier. I've been using the analytical procedure in my research by calculating the sales growth, the growth rate, the earnings per share, the enterprise value divided by revenues, to get an idea of which company could give us more net earnings by investing them. The work I have left is to have an estimate the future operation of these two companies, and to estimate their sales growth rate and how their future will go. Thank you so much.